What we're going to do is we're going to compare players. We're going to compare their stat lines. Both these players are pitchers, and we're looking at only at 2021 numbers. Player A has a 2.85 ERA. He has a 1.51 ERA plus. For those who don't know, ERA plus is out of 100, and 100 is league average. Anything above 100 is good. Anything below 100 is below average. Player A has a 7.1 hits per 9, 1.3 homers per 9, 2.5 walks per 9, a 10.0 strikeouts per 9. Player B has a 3.18 ERA, a 1.41 ERA plus, 10 points lower, a lower FIP, a higher WHIP, a better homer hits per 9, 6.8, better homers 9, 1.0 compared to 1.3, a higher walks per 9, 3.0 to 2.5, and a higher strikes per 9, 10.8 to 10. So who would you take, player A or player B? Personally, I would take player A. Player A has a higher ERA plus, which is stat based out of the average, and a higher FIP, which is a great stat for German pitchers. Player A is Nestor Cortes Jr., one of the unsung heroes for the Yankees this season. He's been great once he's moved to the starting role in his 13 starts. Player B is Shohei Ohtani, the most likely AL MVP. Now, both these guys are 26 years old and have dealt with some struggles to get where they are this season. Shohei dealt with injuries. Nestor Cortes just wasn't as good as he's been this year. And Nestor has been great for the Yankees. He's helped them to get where they are. He's been great when they had injuries, when they dealt with some COVID issues. And he's just been exciting to watch, and he's really got everybody excited. Now, why I'm comparing Nestor and Shohei is because many people don't realize how good Nestor Cortes has been this season. He's a guy that his fastball tops at about 92 miles an hour. He's not blowing it past anybody, but he's funky. He uses different deliveries. He's got good off-speed stuff. And he just gets better out. His biggest thing is he pitches to weak contact. If we look at his baseball savant numbers compared to his teammate and the Yankees ace, Gerrit Cole. Gerrit Cole is in the 53rd percentile for hard hit baseballs, where Nestor Cortes is in the 70th percentile for hard hit baseballs. This is a stat that is usually dominated by relievers because they're short outings and they just don't get hit hard as much. Coming out of the bullpen, they throw as hard as they can. They use their best stuff right away. And they're often a lot wilder, less stuff over the plate, because they have high leverage situations, tough to make mistakes. So for starters, a lot of times you get a hard hit single and it's just like, okay, what it is, whatever it is. Or you'll be up 2 runs and you throw a pitch down the middle because you don't want to walk a guy and they hit a home run. It doesn't matter, you're still up by 1. So hard, it's a stat that starters don't usually tend to focus about, but Nestor Cortes is significantly better than Gerrit Cole, who makes $300 million more than he does. For those of you that don't know about Nestor Cortes, 47% of his pitches are fastball. He does average about 91 miles an hour. 23% of his pitches are his cutter at 85 miles an hour. 20% of his pitches are his slider at 77 miles an hour. And 10% of his pitches are his changeup at 83 miles an hour. So with this mix, cutter, slider, and changeup, he's mixing movement. He has his cutter that'll break one way, his changeup that'll break down and away, and his slider that's slower and will break more than the cutter. Obviously, he has the fastball to just mix up speeds, and that also will break up away from the cutter a little bit. His fastball velocity is in the 6th percentile for MLB's pitchers, which is not very good. That is significantly low, and this just shows how good of a pitcher he is. He's not a thrower. He's a pure pitcher. He knows how to pitch. He knows how to get guys out, and he knows how to expand the strike zone and get swings on some pretty bad pitches. As you can see in some of these highlights, some of these pitches are nowhere in the strike zone and batters swing at it because they know he's going to make a competitive pitch, and they expect it out of him, and they know they can hit it because of the low speed, but they end up not being able to hit it because of the advanced movement. So why has Nestor been so important to the Yankees this season? So besides him just being a fan favorite and a very lovable pitcher and someone who's exciting to watch, he's been needed. The Yankees have had tons of injuries as starting pitcher. Jordan Montgomery's missed a significant amount of time. Gerrit Cole's missed some time.
And hopefully we'll see him continue to pitch. And Corey Kluber's missed most of the
season. And as we all know, Luis Severino has just made his return just recently. And he has been out this entire season. So the Yankees have needed pitching, and they've needed it badly. They've had other guys step in, but no one stepped in the way Nestor Cortes has. He's completely stolen a spot, and he's been pitching great ever since he was given an opportunity. The Yankees will continue to use him, and hopefully we'll see him in his playoff run.